Hi folks, welcome back to the Sticker Channel. Today, we're going to talk about a subject that some may be considering controversial. It's a pet peeve of mine. We're going to talk about making mock scrapes. And I'm going to show you how I do them and explain to you some of my pet peeves about what other people do and why I do them the way I do them. Now first of all, I pick a spot. And I've just mocked this area up for video purposes. I take a spot and I clear out some debris and kick up the dirt, get a fresh spot going here. And then I find some overhanging limbs over top of this area. And what I like to do is I like to go to the dollar store and buy tampons for my scent wick. And what I do with it is I get a good scent that is preorbital scent mixed with eye gland, ear gland, saliva. If you look around, you can find good scent like that online. I buy it and I load that wick up with that scent. I get some branches and bust them over. I'm using latex gloves the whole time. I bust these over, crush some of the tips, make this licking branch here. And then in the dirt, I find some old debris, maybe some dry leaves or whatever. And I would set them in there, you know, off to the side or whatever. And I would put my interdigital in my urines in here, some in the dirt, some in the leaves, disperse it, and that's how I like to do them. See, what my problem is we've got guys that are spraying their deer urine up into these licking branch areas. They spray it in the dirt, and then they come up here and they spray it up here too. And I'm not too sure that Mr. Big likes putting his face up in this licking branch and having urine in his face. Just my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you guys can make some comments down below and tell me how you do it and if it's worked for you. I mean, I've done it that way in the past and it's worked. But usually it's little guys. Out of curiosity, they'll come in and put their face in this, and not for too long they move on. They don't even work. They usually don't work the scrape. But last year I used all this method that I'm showing you here, and there's a tree here. If I can get my hand in right here, this tree behind me, I put a trail camera up in that tree and it looks down over top of the scrape, and I caught Mr. Big around Thanksgiving week coming in and working the scrape. And like I said, just one of my pet peeves. I don't understand why the guys are spraying the urine up in the tree where the licking branch is supposed to be. Get yourself a good preorbital scent. What I do, buy it by the larger quantity, and I come in here and I get it squirted on this wick. If I can get it to squirt, I don't have that much left in there, but I get it on that wick. Okay, get it on the branches, get it on some of this overhanging stuff, so when they put their face up in here, you know. And like I said, then I go to the grind and I would get my favorite scent of choice down in here. And I would get this spread out here. Okay. And that's, you're gonna wanna add some interdigital to your urine so that it's authentic. That's how the deer really interpret who they're leaving their sign to. They check the urine and the interdigital between the hooves, and then up in the tree they get the preorbital, the eye glands, the head glands, the earwax, saliva from the lips and the mouth. That's how they communicate, folks. And you know, that's my 2 cents for today. How about leaving me something down below? Tell me how you do it, or if you're old school and you still put the urine up in the tree. Give me your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Check you later. Bye.